My name is Salome. I'm from Kenya, but I was born in Rwanda. I have a problem with my husband, and sometimes you don't say thinking that I want to run away. But if anything comes up, like a problem like that one, you have to pay all your savings that you don't have anything else to. So that is what I did. It was very painful to leave her because she was the only girl, but I didn't have any otherwise. When I came here, I didn't know anyone. I claimed asylum, and they moved me from Essex to Birmingham. They say the house is furnished where you are going, but it's only a bed and a pair of beddings, and two plates and a pot and a cup. It's where we used to go to get our vouchers. We met people and they introduced us to Nadex.
Often when people come, they've left their family, the whole family's been fragmented. Women have seen horrific things like their husbands and loved ones killed in front of their eyes. When they enter the UK, our asylum system is very, very complicated. So it's advocating on behalf of these ladies, getting them the support they need.
They help us in so many different ways. You need some help like filling your forms. They have a drop-in on Thursdays. They gave us food, which we could not be able to buy, and some clothes.
What about this one?
Oh, yes, definitely, yeah.
It's such a joy to be able to give things that people give us. And for people who don't have, when we have so much, you know, this breaks my heart, so.
The seat can move.
Kareem, look at this one. Is that nice?
Yes. When you come here, you talk, you share, you forget about everything. You forget about your problems. When you are far away, you can't think that you can get people like that who can help you. They doesn't know you, and they take interest to know you, to help you. It's like a family. They are not like strangers.
We share their grief. And we share their joys. Throughout the Bible, God is constantly saying, do not forget the poor. That's where God's heart is. So as the church, that's where our heart should be.
The gospel isn't just about preaching the good news of Christ. It is that, very much so. But when we look at the passage which Jesus took from Isaiah to himself, it was also preaching to the poor and caring for the poor and the dispossessed. It's that connection which makes the gospel whole, that we are caring for the whole of people. Too often churches have moved away from the community and become inward looking, become concerned about their own maintenance, their own spiritual welfare, without actually going out into the community. Because if you go out into the community, your spiritual welfare will grow, your spiritual awareness will grow. Your whole sense of mission will grow. Now we have a whole upper floor, which is the resource centre for refugees and asylum seekers. While we can fund a little of it, there is no way that we are able to fund the scale of the need to meet the need that there is in the area. Where do we find the resources? In parishes such as this, where we have a congregation. Less than 10 people working, many new immigrants who have limited income, some no income at all. And they need our support, and we need the support of the wider church to support them. We do it as an expression of God's love, which is shown to us through Christ. This is not the kind of fasting I have chosen, to loose the chains of injustice and untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free. Is it not to share your food with the hungry and to provide the poor wanderer with shelter? When you see the naked, to clothe him. Then your light will break forth like the dawn, and your healing will quickly appear. Then you will call, and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help, and he will say, "Here I am."